In the last lecture, we saw using a clipping path and using an alpha channel give different results. There are two main reasons for this: the PDF version you use and image resolution. To understand the harsh edge on the left, we first look at how PDF version relates to transparency. Here we have an orange shape that I made transparent so you can look through it. Now let's make a PDF. I click on the save as PDF icon. Scribus now checks for incompatibilities with PDF version 1.3. And we see, for PDF version 1.3, transparency and blending modes are not allowed. Let's click on ignore errors and see what happens. I click on save. When I open the PDF, we see transparency and blending modes are both ignored. In Scribus, I click on the save as PDF icon again. When I click on PDF 1.3, I get a list of PDF versions. The X variants I discuss later in the course. See what happens with the warnings when I choose PDF version 1.4. The warnings disappeared. I ignore the text overflow warning, informing me not all text is displayed inside one of the frames, and click on ignore errors. Behind compatibility, here I also select PDF 1.4. I click on save. When we open the PDF, we see transparency and blending modes are both applied. So why is PDF version 1.3 in the list? The reason is that some printing houses ask for it. The lower the PDF version, the less printing mistakes that can happen. A PDF is not printed directly, but first has to go through some specific software that translates the PDF content to the printing plates. And here mistakes can happen, especially with transparent objects. Different printing houses use different printers, so the software on these printers also differs. And newer printers may handle the transparency translation better than older printers. So printing houses always try to have the printing result as predictable as possible. Because printing thousands of flyers or folders a second time is not an option. Now we know what transparency is, and that you need PDF version 1.4 or higher to include it in your PDF, let's revisit our two transparent images. If we compare PDF 1.3 and 1.4, we see the edge in 1.4 is much less harsh. The reason for this is that in PDF 1.3, all the transparent pixels are refused, and therefore omitted. In PDF 1.4, the edge of an alpha channel is still not as sharp as the edge of a clipping path, but at least looks natural. If PDF 1.3 is required, and you don't have a clipping path, but only an alpha channel, a higher image resolution can improve the edge. This is the image at 300 dpi, so the resolution is good. But we saw with PDF 1.3, even though the resolution is not below 300 dpi, the edge won't look good. The only solution is to increase the resolution, so increase the amount of pixels. To do this, in GIMP, go to Image, Scale Image. I will make the image 4 times larger. I will go from 1000 by 1000 pixels to 4000 by 4000 pixels. It will not help making the image look sharper, but it will improve the edge. In the next lecture, we will look at the different ways to make text flow around an image.